We're going to talk a lot about this over the next week, about the notions of universal awesomeness. Is the Waffle House universally awesome?
We have one choice for late night eating, and it's the Waffle House. And they create this environment where no matter how blitzed you are or how normal you are welcome and treated equally with an experience. It's not just like, you know, eating a plate of food.
You're talking about like it's a magical spiritual place.
No, it's beyond a magical spiritual place.
Gentlemen.
Oh.
Oh, the pecan waffle. You just crush it. You put every...
Just slather it.
I want it to be swimming in syrup and homogenized vegetable oil.
Oh, that's good. That's good.
See, you don't come here expecting the French Laundry. You come here expecting something amazing.
This is better than the French Laundry, man.
And then, second course, patty melt, split.
Oh, patty melt!
Oh. Oh. Come on. That's not insanely delicious.
Oh.
Insanely delicious.
No meal is complete without sunny side up
eggs. Oh, yeah.
And then a green salad with some Thousand Island dressing would be amazing. Would you rather have thin-cut pork chops or a T-bone?
I would like both.
Heinz 57 is the best, man. One of the more complex sauces
what
in the American repertoire.
Really?
You want to talk about it? This is sauce work. Trust me, this is gonna change your life. Mmm.
No, you're wrong. I'm sorry. Here's where we part ways, my friend. Here's my sauce.
After a few bites of waffle, a burger, a hunk of generic T-bone and some hash browns, one feels drawn right to the center of what makes our country great. An America, yeah moment that drives me to clamber up on the counter and start reciting Walt Whitman, the Star-Spangled Banner, Jose, Can You See, and you know what? I doubt I'd be the first.